Hi friends, how are you all? I hope you all are doing well. My name is Sanju and welcome to my channel English with Sanju. In this video, I will continue the reading of Jane Eyre chapter 2. The name of the chapter is Lowood. And one morning, almost 4 months later, Bessie came into my room. Mrs. Reed wants you to go to the sitting room immediately, she said. I was very frightened when she said this, but I had to go downstairs. A very tall man, dressed in black, was standing in front of the fire in the sitting room. His face was serious and he did not smile once during the talk which followed. He looked at me for a minute and then asked, "She's very small. How old is she?" 10, Mrs. Brocklehurst, my aunt replied. "Really, she looks younger." Then he turned to me, "What is your name?" "Jane Eyre, sir," I answered. "Are you a good child?" he continued. Here my aunt spoke. "Jane Eyre is a wicked child. I want her to go to your school at Lowood. I want her to grow up into a better person." When Mrs. Reed said this, I hated her more than ever before. How could she talk about me like this, especially to a stranger? Mr. Brocklehurst would think of me as a wicked child forever. "Well, Mrs. Reed," said Mr. Brocklehurst, "I will tell Miss Temple, the head teacher of Lowood, that a new girl will be arriving soon. I shall also tell her what you have told me about this child." And so my aunt's bad opinion of me went ahead of me to Lowood. I left Gateshead very early in the morning. Only Bessie got up to say goodbye to me. It was night when I arrived to Lowood, but I could just see a long low building. I was taken into a sitting room. A tall dark-haired woman with a kind face came in. When she saw me, she asked, "You must be Jane Eyre. You are very young to travel alone. Is this the first time that you have left your mother and father?" I explained that I was an orphan. She asked me how old I was, and then she said, "I hope you'll be a good girl at Lowood, Jane." Then a teacher took me to have supper. We walked into a large room. It was full of girls of every age. There were about 80 of them, and all wore ugly brown dresses and heavy shoes. Even the prettiest girls looked strange. They were learning their lessons for the next day. Suddenly a voice said, "Bring the food for supper." But when the food arrived, I saw that there was only bread and water. There was so little that the meal ended very quickly. Then we went into bed. I woke up the next morning when the bell rang. My life at Lowood School had really begun. We went down to the schoolroom. There was one teacher for each of the four classes in the room. I was put in the lowest class. For an hour we had lessons and then it was time for breakfast. I was so hungry that I almost felt ill. But the smell of the food was so terrible that one could not eat very much. We returned to our lessons until noon. Then we all went outside into the garden for half an hour. It was very cold and we had very thin coats. Some of the girls coughed a lot. Too many girls had